we gather our equipment.
So we need a wound dressing. Check it's in date, please. So we need our synthetic bandage, a conforming bandage, our protective bandage. We need some cotton wool. We need a splint, that's the right size. And we need bandage scissors. This one also needs some zinc oxide tape because we need to stabilize the splint in place. So we're going to cut two strips. It's always wiser to get your strips ready before you put on your gloves because the tape would stick to your gloves. Okay, gloves on. Prepare all your equipment. So you unwrap all the bandaging. We have to place our patient into lateral recumbency, so very gently you're going to lift your patient. Place them into lateral recumbency and make sure your affected limb is uppermost because that's the one you're going to be working with. Okay, so we're going to get our assistant to give us some help. So we're going to get our assistant to secure the patient's head and just hold the leg like this. Okay, thank you. So we need to address our wound first. Open the wound packaging. We check for the shiny side. You lift from the back and you place it carefully onto your wound. Make sure your wound's completely covered. And you can just use a small piece of your synthetic bandage to keep it in place. Now, we're going to pad between our toes for the patient comfort. Now we need to apply our padding there, all the way up the limb, right up and over the elbow. So we start at the distal end and we work proximal. And each time you're covering your previous layer by 50% to keep your tension even the entire length of the bandage. So you make sure you go right up, cover your elbow, because you don't want the splint to stick into the back. Okay, and we need to give it another layer. So again, start at your foot. Overlap by 50%. Keep your tension even. To place our splint. You need to check your splint. If your splint has sharp edges, you want to put a little bit more padding over the top of the splint. Don't put it in at the end because then your bandage gets very tight. So caudal aspect of the limb, we place the splint to make sure that it incorporates the carapace and the elbow so that the leg is immobile. And then we'll hold it in place with our two strips of tape. You need to be careful with these that you don't put them on too tight and cause an area where there's pressure within the bandage. Okay, now we put our conforming layer on. Again, we start at the foot and we work distal to proximal. Same principle applies, so we're going to overlap by 50% with each turn. And go right up and incorporate the end of the splint bandage. Now, finally, our protective layer. 50% or whatever each time. Just make sure your bandage isn't going on too tight. So you roll out a little bit and then you place it around the limb. Right up and over the edge of your splint. So you don't want to see any pieces of padding when you're finished. Okay, so remove the excess. Check your tension, so you should be easily able to get two fingers in there. And then we're going to tuck in our edges. Check there's no sharp edge on our splint. Our tension's fine.